How to avoid retyping error messages. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I can't tell you the number of times that somebody's asked me a question and I've responded by saying, okay, what was the error message? What was the exact wording of the error message? And of course, the concept of having to necessarily retype the entire error message is pretty daunting for a lot of folks. Set screenshots aside for a moment. There might in fact be an easier way. Let's have a quick look at Windows 11 and I'll show you exactly what I mean. I'm going to run a program that doesn't exist. Something called Notepad. I don't think Notepad exists. And of course, great, there's an error message. Okay, there are three things you can do with this. One, you can try and scribble it down, right? You could try to retype it by hand. Two, you could take a screenshot. And absolutely, screenshots are wonderful. But there's something else. I'm going to click on this and I'm going to click or type CTRL+C. Now you may not have heard it. There was a blip on my side. It may be completely silent. That's okay. Now I'm actually going to run what I probably intended to run in the first place, right? Was Notepad. And now I'm going to hit paste. Well, look at that. It's the text of the error message that I happened to type CTRL+C on when it was displayed. This is perfect. No typos, not the overhead of an image or having to deal with screenshots, just the text. Now, I have to be clear. This works with many, but not all, Windows default messages. And that doesn't necessarily mean it's Windows only. I mean, if a program uses one of Windows default message display techniques, their messages may work this way too, but it may not, right? If you do the copy thing and then you come back to something like Notepad and you paste and there's nothing there or it's not what you thought was going to get pasted, then maybe this won't work in that scenario. But especially in these simple scenarios where we've got just a message box that says something went wrong, okay. This is a great way to grab that error message text without having to basically do more work than you really need to do. Hope that's helpful. Like I said, if you do end up encountering an error message and you end up asking me or anyone else a question about it, here's an easy way to copy and paste that message into your email or wherever so that you're actually providing the exact information along with your question. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/1870. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.